Hare Krishna. The meeting of Anirudh and Usha, which caused a great fight between Lord Krishna and Lord Shiva, taken from Bhagavad Puran, Canto 10. This is a very mysterious and interesting story. Maharaj Parikshit was eager to hear the whole story from Shukdev Goswami, and thus Shukdev narrated it. My dear king, you must have heard the name of King Bali. He was a great devotee who gave away in charity all that he had, namely the whole world, to Lord Vaman, the incarnation of Vishnu as a dwarf Brahman. King Bali had 100 sons, and the eldest of all of them was Banasur. This Banasur, born of Maharaj Bali, was a great devotee of Lord Shiva and was always ready to render service unto him. By the grace of Lord Shiva, Banasur had 1,000 arms, and he became so powerful that even demigods like King Indra were serving him most obediently. Long ago, when Lord Shiva was dancing in his celebrated fashion called Tandav Nritya, for which he is known as Nataraj, Banasur helped Lord Shiva in his dancing by rhythmically beating drums with his 1,000 hands. Being pleased with Banasur, he said, "Whatever you desire, you can have from me, for I am very much pleased with you." Banasur replied, "My dear Lord, if you please, you can remain in my city just to protect me from the hands of my enemies." Once upon a time, while offering his respectful obeisances, Banasur said, "My dear Lord, you have given me 1,000 arms, but I do not know what to do with them. They are simply a burden. I cannot use them properly in fighting, since I cannot find anyone competent to fight with me except your lordship, the original father of the material world. So I satisfy the itching of my arms by beating them against the mountains. In this way, I tear many great mountains to pieces." Lord Shiva realized that his benediction had become troublesome for Banasur and addressed him, "You rascal, you are very eager to fight, but since you have no one to fight with you, you are distressed. Although you think that there is no one in the world to oppose you except me, I say that you will eventually find such a competent person. At that time, your days will come to an end, and your flag of victory will no longer fly. Then you will see your false prestige smashed to pieces." After hearing Lord Shiva's statement, Banasur, who was very much puffed up with his power, became elated that he would meet someone able to smash him to pieces. He was such a foolish demon. It appears that foolish, demoniac human beings, when unnecessarily overpowered with material opulences, want to exhibit these opulences, and such foolish people feel satisfaction when these opulences are exhausted. The idea is that they do not know how to expend their energy for the right causes, being unaware of the benefit of Krishna consciousness. In contrast to Banasur, Arjun also possessed extraordinary powers for fighting, but he utilized them only for Krishna. Banasur had a very beautiful daughter, whose name was Usha. When she had attained the age of marriage and was sleeping amongst her many girlfriends, she dreamt one night that Anirudh was by her side and that she was enjoying a conjugal relationship with him, although she had never actually seen him or even heard of him before. She awoke from her dream, exclaiming very loudly, "My dear beloved, where are you?" Being exposed to her friends in this way, she became a little embarrassed. One of Usha's girlfriends was Chitralekha, who was the daughter of Banasur's prime minister. So out of great curiosity, Chitralekha asked Usha, "My dear beautiful princess, as of yet you are not married to any young boy, nor have you ever seen any boys until now. So I am surprised that you are exclaiming like this. Who are you searching after? who is your suitable match? Usha replied, My dear friend, in my dream I saw a nice young man who is very, very beautiful. His complexion is swarthy. His eyes are just like lotus petals. And he is dressed in yellow garments. His arms are very long and his general bodily features are so pleasing that any young girl would be attracted. But I am sorry to inform you that just after this, he disappeared. And I have been thrown into the whirlpool of disappointment. My dear friend, I am very anxious to find this wonderful young man, the desired lord of my heart. After hearing Usha's words, Chitralekha immediately replied, I can understand your bereavement. It doesn't matter where he is. I know the art of bringing him here. So as soon as you identify him, I shall immediately arrange for it. Chitralekha, while talking, began to draw many pictures of the demigods inhabiting the higher planetary systems. Then pictures of the Gandharvas, Siddhas, Charans, Panags, Daityas, Vidyadhars and Yakshas, as well as many pictures of human beings. The statements of Srimad Bhagavatam and other Vedic literatures prove definitely that on each and every planet there are living entities of different varieties. Therefore, it is foolish to assert that there are no living entities but those on this earth. Coming back to the story, when Usha saw the picture of Anirudh, she became so bashful that she immediately lowered her head and smiled, having found the man she was seeking. She identified the picture to Chitralekha as that of the man who had stolen her heart. Chitralekha was a great mystic yogini and could immediately understand that it was of Anirudh, a grandson of Krishna's, although neither she nor Usha had previously known his name or ever seen him. That very night, she travelled in outer space and within a very short time reached the city of Dwarka, which was well protected by Lord Krishna. She entered the palace and found Anirudh sleeping in his bedroom on a very opulent bed. Chitralekha, by her mystic power, immediately brought Anirudh in that sleeping condition to the city of Sonitpur so that Usha might see her desired husband. Usha immediately bloomed in happiness and began to enjoy the company of Anirudh with great satisfaction. The palace in which Usha and Chitralekha lived was so well fortified that it was impossible for any male to either enter or even see inside. Usha and Anirudh lived together in the palace, and day after day, Usha's love for Anirudh grew 4 times upon 4. Usha pleased Anirudh with valuable garments, flowers, garlands, scents, and incense. By his bedside sitting place were other paraphernalia for residential purposes, like nice drinks, such as milk and sherbet, nice eatables, which could be chewed or swallowed. Above all, she pleased him with sweet words and very obliging service. Usha worshipped Anirudh as if he were the supreme personality of Godhead. By her excellent service, Usha made Anirudh forget all other things and was able to draw his attention and love to her without deviation. In such an atmosphere of love and service, Anirudh practically forgot himself and could not recall how many days he had been away from his real home in Dwarka. In due course of time, Usha exhibited some bodily symptoms by which it could be understood that she was closely in association with a male friend. The symptoms were so prominent that her actions could no longer be concealed from anyone. The housekeeper and the guards of the palace could guess very easily that she was having relations with a male friend. And without waiting for further developments, all of them informed their master, Banasur. In the Vedic culture, an unmarried girl having association with a male is the greatest disgrace to the family. So the caretakers cautiously informed their master that Usha was showing symptoms indicating a disgraceful association. The servants were not at all neglectful in guarding the house, being alert day and night against any young man who might enter. They were so careful that a male could not even see what was going on there. And so they were surprised, since they could not trace out the reason for it. Banasur was shocked to understand that his daughter Usha was in close association with a man. This weighed heavily on his heart, and without any delay, he rushed toward the palace where Usha was living with Anirudh. He saw that Usha and Anirudh were sitting together and talking. They looked very beautiful together, Anirudh being the son of Pradyumna, who was Cupid himself. Banasur saw his daughter and Anirudh as a suitable match. Yet, for family prestige, he did not like the combination at all. Banasur could not understand who the boy actually was. He appreciated the fact that Usha could not have selected anyone in the three worlds more beautiful. Still, Banasur was very angry. Anirudh was engaged in playing with Usha. Banasur was struck with wonder that even in his presence, Anirudh was peacefully sitting in front of Usha. Anirudh knew, however, that his would-be father-in-law was not at all pleased and that he was gathering many soldiers in the palace to attack him. Thus, not finding any other weapon, Anirudh took hold of a big iron rod and stood up before Banasur and his soldiers. He firmly took a posture, indicating that if anyone attacked, he would strike all of the soldiers down to the ground with the iron rod. Banasur and his company of soldiers saw that the boy was standing before them just like a superintendent of deaths with his invincible rod. Now, under the order of Banasur, the soldiers from all sides attempted to capture and arrest him. When they dared to come before him, Anirudh struck them with the rod, breaking their heads, legs, arms and thighs, and one after another, they all fell to the ground. He killed them just as the leader of a pack of boars kills barking dogs one after another. In this way, Anirudh was able to escape the palace. Banasur knew various arts of fighting, and by the grace of Lord Shiva, he knew how to arrest his enemy by the use of Nagpash, that is, snake noose, and thus he seized Anirudh as he came out of the palace. When Usha received the news that her father had arrested Anirudh, she was overwhelmed with grief and confusion. Tears glided down from her eyes, and being unable to check herself, she began to cry very loudly. How this resulted in the most ferocious battle between Lord Shiva and Lord Shri Krishna, we will cover in our next video. For the greatest battle that turned the universe, stay connected with Vedic Tales. In the Bhagavad Puran, it is assured that anyone who remembers in the morning the narration of the following fight between Lord Krishna and Lord Shiva will never experience defeat anywhere in his struggle of life. So please watch with great attention our next Vedic Tales video. Hare Krishna.